Welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to talk about how to program SE10 controller from Banner Engineering. So I've created some simple tasks to understand how to use the safety input devices and how to actuate the output. I must tell you this, when you're programming this SE10 controller, the programmer is solely responsible for the safety circuit designing. In this video, I'm just going to tell you how to use the software program to program your safety circuits. You have to be responsible for what you're designing in your application. So let's start with some basic examples. We have the first task. It says use a magnetic door switch to create a safety circuit for RO1. So we have a magnetic door switch which is connected to IN1 and IN2, having a supply from I01, and this should control your RO1. This is your first relay output. And if you want to see the wiring of the sensor, it is connected to IN1 and IN2. And if you notice IN2, this is going inside the sensor and it is having some magnetic contacts and it's coming back with a loop and going back to IN1. So IN1 is having an NC contact and IN2 is having an NO contact of this magnetic switch. So magnetic switch has one part on the top, another part on the bottom. So here you can see that this is the part on the top and that's the actuator. Okay, so we have to control the output RO1 using this magnetic switch. So let's see how we can do that. The first step is we start the software. So I will type Banner Safety Controller and this will start the software. And here we have to select our controller, which is SE10, and press on continue. And this will take a couple of seconds to start the startup screen of the software. And in this example, it's relatively simple. We have just one input device. So from our safety gate, we just use one input device, which is my magnetic switch. We will come to this other safety inputs later in the video. So you have to accept the terms and condition, as I explained in the last video, that you're responsible for your programming and for your safety circuit. Click OK. And now, when you see the equipment here, we have the controller already selected. We just did that. So it automatically gives you two outputs, RO1 and RO2. In our case, we just use RO1. Okay, we can leave it as default. Now we have to add an input. For that, you can just click on this plus button, and then you will find safety inputs, non-safety inputs, and status outputs. In our case, it's a safety input. So in safety input, I will select a gate switch, which is quite relevant to our magnetic switch. So we click on this one and then you will see different terminal configuration. And if you notice in our task, we have a configuration of three terminal complementary. If one is NO, another is NC. This gives you extra security. So you can select this by navigating on the sidebar. So on the top, you have single terminal, and then you have single channel two terminals and then single channel PNP. So if you come down, you will find complementary two terminals. In our case, it's three terminals. So this IO1 is already connected in my sensor. So if you see this diagram, we have connected this to IO1 and the signal from the sensor is connected to IN1 and IN2. So this is the perfect selection for us. So if you want, you can put some name here you want to give to your sensor. So I will write mag switch, magnetic switch, and click OK. Once you do that, you will see your input is defined here. All right. Now we just have to jump to the program. You go to functional view. In the functional view, you will see your input is defined here already and output is already here. All you have to do is you just have to connect this input with the output. This is a simple task. So in this case, I will just connect this, drag and drop here. Now this is connected. That's it. This is the simplest way to program it without entering single piece of code. Now you have to do is you have to just download this program. In this case, you can click on this button with the red down arrow. It says write configuration to controller. I will click on this one and write configuration to controller again. It asks me to save your project. I will say yes, and I will save it as task one, so which is here already defined, and save. And under confirmation, yes, and it will ask for the password. So it could be possible your controller already has a password defined inside. If yes, then enter your password. Click OK. and then it will ask you, it will inform you once you start downloading, outputs will be off, which is okay in our case. Continue. So it will write the program, and then it will ask you to confirm what you just did. So here you can see that this is your module, that's your configuration, that's the inputs and outputs which we are using, and that's the response time, which is 75 milliseconds. Click confirm, and then in the end, when everything is completed, you can press close. And then if he asks you to change the password, I don't want to. In this case, it asks you if you want to save your configuration, and for the effect to take place, you have to restart your controller. Okay, so I don't want to save it now. I click close, and now I have to restart my controller. In this case, I will just turn off the power supply from this cable, and so I will just unplug it and plug it again. So I will unplug it. So this will turn off the controller because 24 volt is gone, and then plug it again. Okay, now I have added an extra relay here. So if you notice here, this relay is connected to my terminal number 13 and 14. So 13, 14 is my NO contact. Okay, so to 13 I have provided 24 volts. 14 is going to the relay coil and it's getting 0 volt directly. So in this case, if my RO1 is true, the relay will also get true. Now everything looks fine in our case, so let's check it out. How does it work? So I have to bring my relay, my contact towards this, and to see if the output gets on or not. So now you can see that once this contact is closed with this gate switch, your output RO1 is true, which makes the relay true as well. Okay, so here you can see that again. Now it's off and it's on again. So let me just save this project. And if you want to see how this looks online, you should be able to do that. Let me just plug out and plug in my programming cable sometime. Otherwise, you will see a button here. There it is. So once you click on the live mode, you would be able to see the status of your IOs. So at the moment, this is true, which makes my output true. If this is false, this will turn off my output. Very easy. You can see the same status in your wiring diagram. You can see here the status of your IOs and status of your output. You can see the same status in your live mode. This is your switch, which is in run mode. This is stop, output is stop, on again. And in the ISD, you may not see because this is not IC terminal. So this was about how you can use a magnetic door switch and actuate your output. So this is a very simple task. In the next task, we have to add an RF switches in series to the magnetic door switch. So we'll be using these two switches, which you see on the sensor kit in red color, in series with this door switch to actuate the same output. And these series of the switches we're going to do in ISD, in series diagnostics. So let's see that in the next video. Bye.